Hello students, welcome to RDBMS online classes. In the previous class, we have completed about the TCL commands and also we have completed about the where class and order by classes also. But in this today's session, we have to learn about the group by class. Now, let us start our session. Okay. Explain in detail about group by class in SQL. The group by class, the group by statement, groups the rows that have the same values into the summary rows. Like find the number of customers in each country. This is an example. Just try to understand. Here, the group by statement is often used with aggregate functions. Group by statement is used to what purpose? Groups the rows that have the same values into rows. Carefully observe here. Here I am showing one output for you. Here select a star from EMP. Now in this, how many records we have? 1, 2, 3, 4. So 4 persons we have now. John, Peter. Got it? Here 2 persons data we have, not 4 persons data. Try to understand this one. Records are 4, but persons are 2 only. John, Peter. Okay? IDs also same. 101, 102, 102. Nothing but this EMP table contain 2 persons data, not 4 persons data. So, one person can have to work in different department also. Got it? One person can have a chance to work in different departments. For example, you have to take sweeper. Sweeper can sweep the floor in classes also, and also office also, and also library. And one sweeper can sweep these many work in these many departments. Got it? Now you got a clarity with an example, which is I have given right now. So now let us understand. Here, different places the person data we have added. 101 John, and nothing but 2 times it has added, and salaries are different. In the first department, 10,000 salary he is taking. In the second department, 15,000 salary he is taking. Like Peter also same, 20,000 is one place, Peter is in, 25,000 in some other place, some other department. Just assume the data compared to real time data. So now I want to get this 2 person data, how much they are getting the salary. How much the salary they are getting? 10,000 plus 15,000, 20,000 plus 25,000. Like that, how we can fetch the data. So here, in this same table, the same persons we have or not? Yes, we have the same persons. But same persons are getting the salary from different sources or not? Yeah, that is also obviously right. How you can group all together that salaries? By using group by class. Group by class is groups the rows. Got it? Now got the clarity in this definition? The group by class is groups the rows that have the same values into summary. Find the number of customers in each country. This is one example. Here I have shown different example for you. 2 examples you have to take and execute and understand that one. And group by statement or group by class is often used with aggregate functions. Group by class is often used with aggregate functions. What are the aggregate functions we have? Count function, max function, min function, sum function, average function. To group the result set by one or more columns, we can use these many functions. Okay, we can use these many functions to group the data. So now we have to sum of the salaries data for that same persons. Okay, so for that we can use the sum statement na? On salary table. On salary table we can use sum statement. So what is the syntax here? Select column 1 function name. Select column 1 function name from table 1. Which is the table we have? Where condition. Group by class, order by class. So this is the process. Select star from table name, where class, group by, order by. And these light color names are expressions. Select column 1. Nothing but in this table name, in this table you can get column 1 and function name also. Function name. We can use the grouping function there. Got it? So that is the syntax of group by class. Now let us understand about the practical way. Select star from EMP. So EMP data we don't have right now. So now I want to create one EMP data. Create table EMP, create table EMP, ID, EID number, EID number 3, E name, varchar 2, 20, salary, number, 5 digits. Okay. Now the table has created with 3 columns. Employee ID, employee name, employee salary. Okay. Now I am inserting the data. Insert into EMP values. The ID is, first record ID is 101. Name is Priyanka. Okay, we class lo unna andaru priyankalu iskondi 25,000 is salary and 102 priyanka kadu Ali. Okay, Ali, 35,000. Okay, second record. Now I am inserting 101 record, Priyanka, 20,000, and Priyanka is working also in some other department. So that's why for that also she is getting 20,000 salary. In previous 25,000 salary she is getting from some other department, and she is also sometimes she is cooperating with some other department also. So that's why they are also paying 20,000 salary. Got it? So like that. If you have same related data, then if you want to group the data, we can use the group by class. Ali. Ali is also same working, same place. So for that, 32,000. Okay, so now I am commit the data. This one I am committing. Okay, commit completed successfully. Transaction successfully completed. So now we have to use the group by class. Select select star from EMP. So now how many records we have? 4 records we have. 101, 102, 101, 102, Priyanka, Ali, Priyanka, Ali, 25,000, 35,000, 20,000, 30,000. Now I want to group the data, the base run salary, how Priyanka is getting, how much salary Priyanka is getting, complete salary, not only single department, not from single department, she's working different departments na, she's working in different departments. So that different departments, how much amount they are paying. Now I want to calculate the total amount of data. So that's why salary column I am grouping. Salary column I am grouping for the Priyanka only or Ali only. So how I can group? Select star from EMP group by salary. Group by salary. Sorry. Select E name. Column names are different, na? E name. Here aggregate function I am using. Carefully observe. Sum of salary from EMP. Group by class I am using. Carefully observe. Group by key name. Carefully observe. Here four records we have, na? Here it is showing after the salary is adding one department to another department, the total salary it is representing on this output. Priyanka is showing getting 45,000, Ali is getting 67,000. Got it? So like that we can combine the data, same data from same table, we can combine the data by using group by class. So that is the group by class functionality. Next, explain in detail about having class. Having class functionality is what? The having class enables you to specify conditions. That filter which group the results appear in the results. The having class enables you to specify conditions. Here I am showing one syntax. Carefully observe. Select a column name from table where class. So this where class is applying the condition. Carefully observe here. Select star from EMP where EID equal to 101. So in this query, select star from EMP, this is statement, where class is used to apply the specific requirement as a condition. We can represent that our specific requirement is represent like a condition or expression. Okay, so here EID equal to 101. So that 101 records are representing on the console, na? So this is condition. Carefully observe here. Like that, this where condition can apply only select statement, not by the group by statement. So where command is where the where class is used to along with select statement, but this is associated with select statement only, not by group by class. So if you want to apply the conditions on group by class, compulsory we must have to use having condition, having command. Where class is associated with select statement and having class is associated with group by class. Because of the having class was added to SQL, because the where keyword cannot be used with aggregate functions. If you want to use the aggregate function with group by class, where is not supporting for this conditions, where is not supported by the aggregate functions. Aggregate functions are what here? Count, max, min, sum, average. Count means it will return the value for how many customers we have in the table. Max means which is the biggest value we have, that it will represent. Min means which is the least value we have in our table, that value it can represent. Sum means if you want to do the sum operation on salary column, that all columns data, all salaries data, it will sum by the itself by using sum condition. Average also gives the represents. Average is also aggregate function. It is used to get the average from the table based on the specific column. So group by class is used to group the results from a table. Having clause is used to having clause is used to apply the conditions along with group by clause because of where clause is not supported with the aggregate functions. So that's why having clause introduced for the group by clause only. The SQL developers having clause has introduced for the group by clause only. So that's why having clause is immediately we can use after group by clause. Okay. So like that. Here I have given example. Carefully observe. Select start from employee. This table data we have. Select department sum of the salary from employee. So department sum of the salary it will represent. Group by department only. Group by department having some salary greater than 25,000. So first select department sum of salary from employee. It will read the data. It will retrieve the data from database. After that it will group by the department. After that, that results it will compare to based on this condition. Who are having the greater than 25,000 salary? In that getting result set, that result it will represent on the console. Carefully observe. 25,000 below data already. 25,000 below data we have or not? No. Because of here we have applied less than 25,000. Not less than or equal 25,000. So that's why 25,000 has excluded in our output. This is previous table. Total table we have. And after review, after executing the group by clause and having clause, this result we are getting. So this having clause is used to apply the conditions along with group by clause. Group by clause generated result set. Having clause is used to apply the conditions based on group by clause generated results. Okay. So like that. Explain in detail about nested queries class in SQL. Nested queries are nothing but already in previous classes in the second semester programming with C and C++. Nested loops, nested control statements we have used it. But somebody know, somebody don't know. Here also I will explain one more time. Don't worry about that. Nested queries are nothing but one query we can write inside of some other query. So that type of queries are called nested queries. So a nested query is a query with another SQL query. And embedded within the where clause. So this nested query we can perform with along with where clause only. A nested query is also called subquery, inner query or inner query. These two names also we can use for the nested queries. Subqueries, nested queries or inner queries. Okay. And the outer query is known as the main query and the inner query is known as the subquery. So these words are already you are getting confusion, I think. Carefully observe here. Select column name. So this is my column name requirement. Select instead of star, we can use the single column names also as per our requirement. Star means all columns. If you don't want all columns, then simply we can use the column name. That particular column it will represent on the console. Okay. That particular column data it will represent on the SQL console. From table name. So this is syntax. Where column name expression operator. Where column name expression operator. This is our syntax. After that, subquery we can write in the brackets. So first the subquery will execute. After that, first the inner query will execute. This last statement is called inner query because of it has written in the where statement, no? Where command. It has written in where clause. So outside starting query is called outer query. After where clause we can use the subquery in between brackets, that is called inner query. So this is syntax. Here I have given example also. Just try to understand. Select star from EMP. Where EID. In is also one of the operator. Comparison operator. In last class, in previous classes already we have discussed about the types of operators. In that, in operator is also one of the special operator to execute some SQL queries. In operator functionality is what? It will search. In between brackets, you can write the subquery. Na? First, this brackets query will execute because of this is inner query. Select EID from EMP. So the total EID first it will get. After that, it will check the condition. Salary greater than 15,000. So greater than 15,000 salary persons, first it will fetch that EIDs. It can assign into this one EID in EID. So both are match and then 25,000 greater than, I mean greater than 15,000 persons, it will represent on the console. So like that, this is inner query, this is outer query, this is sub query, this is super query. Okay, this is sub query or this is main query. So nested queries are nothing but we can write the queries one inside another, one inside another. Select a star from EMP where EID. In operator we can use. If you want to write the sub query, this special operators we can use. Select EID from, select EID from EMP where salary greater than, carefully observe, in 20, 25, 35, 32. So 30,000 we can apply. Just two records it can represent. Okay. So first this query will execute. Select EID from nothing but EID column. First EID column will get from the EMP table. That is also based on this condition. Who are having the 30,000 salary, above 30,000 salary, then that records first it will fetch. Who are having 30 to 35? Ali. Ali having two times. That two records we have. So first these two records, 102 record it will fetch two times. So that two records assign here as a value. So select a star from EMP, nothing but all columns from the EMP where EID in EID. Both are matched, then that data will represent on the console. Got it? So that is the meaning of this. This is called subquery, nested queries. Nested queries. So having class, group class, group by class, having class, where class, order by class, four clauses completed, and TCL commands, DML commands, and DDL commands, DCL commands also completed. Okay, in the next class we will discuss about the in the next class we will discuss about the joins concept. So let us understand about the joins definition right now, today also, and in the next class we have to complete types of joins. What is join? SQL joins are used to relate information in different tables. SQL joins are used to relate information in different tables. Nothing but if you have two tables data, the two tables data at a time we can represent on the console. If you want to see the data, for example, now I want to see one simple example for you. If you have any matched column, create table T1, ID number, name, varchar 2, 10 letters, sorry. Okay, so these two columns I have created. T1 object already we have, so that's why again I am creating. Okay, T10 is my table. Now T11 table is also I am creating. Carefully observe, two tables I have created right now. Now I want to insert the data in first table. Insert into table name is what? T10, values 1 values 1, x, x is the name, x is the name. Okay, two values we have in the table. Got it. Next, second record, 2, y. Y is the second record. Now, I want to insert the data in second table also. T11 table, that one. T11, 1, a. T11, 2, b. So, T table having two records. T11 table having two records. How we can combine? By using join operators, by using joins. Select star from, select star from, select star from T10. Select star from T10. Select star from T10. Union. Select star from T11. So the total data we have combined from different tables now. Select star from T10, select star from T11. So like that, select star from T10 table. So T10 table contains how many records? Two records. T11 contains two records. T11 contains two records. T11 contains two records. XY, AB. This is T10 table, this is T11 table. How we can combine? Select star from T10, union. Select star from T11. So the total two tables data we have combined here now. It is representing all the data from two tables. So like that we can use the joins. SQL joins are used to relate information in different tables. Used to group the information. Group the information in different tables. A join condition is a part of SQL query that retrieves rows from two or more tables. But in all the tables must have one matching column. Carefully observe. This is one way. This is one way. Set operation. By using set operations, we can combine the data. Now, select star from T10. Select star from T10. Select star from T10. Inner join. Inner join. Table 2. T11. T11, just don't confuse. In the next class, I will explain clearly. This is an introduction, that's why. This is just an introduction. But in these two tables, what are the matching columns we have? ID column is also matched column and name column is also matched column. So if you want to combine the multiple tables data, one matched column must and should be required in joins. So here, inner join table 2. On table 1 matching column is what? On T10 dot ID equal to T11 dot ID. Okay, carefully observe. Two tables data, one by one it is representing on the console. Now 1 2 is ID, 1 2 is ID, name XY, name AB. So if you want to compare one table data to some other table, this join process is very 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 important concept. So side by side it is representing. So by looking this data, if you want to compare from one record to another record, it is an easy process to get the result. Right. So that is the joins introduction part. So there are number of types of joins. Inner join, left join, right join, full join, self join. These all are different types of joins. So with the help of these joins, we can combine and represent on the console from multiple tables data in a single query. By using joins are very, very, very important to group the all the data from different tables. But here the major important concept is what? One matching column must and should be required in all tables. If you want to represent the data from all the tables, compulsory one matching column is the mandatory key point. One matching column we must have in every table. So then only the complete data it can fetch from the different tables. We can join the tables. So in the next class we will discuss about the joins concept very clearly. Thank you very much. Today I am going to ending this session.